Brahmavaivrat Purana.
It's the 12th Purana. It contains four parts: Brahma Khand, Prakriti Khand, Ganesh Khand and Shri Krishna Janma Khand. In Naimisharanya Tirth, addressing a gathering of great sages like Shaunak etc., Sutaji has described this Purana as the marvelous creation. This Purana describes the place of the Lord Krishna and Radha in considerable detail. Thus, it is a basic source of inspiration for all the subsequent treatises that depict the life of Radha. It is only Purana that exclusively describes the episodes from the life of Radha, the most beloved lady of Lord Shri Krishna. Brahma Khand, creation of the universe. Origin of Narayana from the body of Shri Krishna. Origin of Radha in Rasamandal. Origin of Gopas, gopis and cows from the bodies of Radha and Krishna. Creation of all other animate and inanimate world.
Prakriti Khand, greatness of Durga, Radha, Lakshmi, Saraswati and Savitri in the creation of the world. Tales of Savitri Satyavan, Surabhi, Swaha, and Swadha.
Description of the clan of Surat.
Tale of Ganga.
Tales from Ramayana. Curse of Durvasa on Indra. Worship of Lakshmi.
Ganesh Khand, mainly discusses about the greatness of Lord Ganesh.
Also contains tales of Jamadagni, Kartavirya, Parshurama etc.
Shri Krishna Khand,
describes the life and place of Lord Shri Krishna. Under the heads of Brajlila, Mathura Lila, reunion of Radha and Krishna. Migration of the residents of Gokul to Gokula. In the opinion of this Purana, there are 10 features of Mahapurana. These are creation, preservation,
pralay,
destruction, fostering,
karma.
Description of lust, description of each of the 14 manas and their dynasties. Description of salvation, recitation of the virtues of Sri Hari and description of the glory of the gods. But Puranas with 5 features and UPA Puranas has following common features. Creation, destruction, description of Chandra and Surya dynasties and their kings and description of the 14 manas. This Purana consists of 32 chapters. Chapter 1 Preliminaries. There was a forest known as Naimisharanya. The sages, Maharshis, arranged for a sacrifice,
Yajna,
in this forest and the ceremony went on for 12 years. Naimisharanya forest was a wonderful place to arrange sacrifices in. The climate was pleasant. There were trees full of climate was pleasant. There were trees full of flowers and fruit. There was no shortage of food in the forest. And animals, birds and sages lived there happily. Many sages came to attend the sacrifice that had been arranged in Naimisharanya. With them was Romaharshana, alternatively Lomaharshana, Vedavyasa's disciple. Vedavyasa had instructed this disciple of his in the knowledge of the Puranas. The assembled sages worshipped the learned Romaharshana and said, "Please tell us the stories of the Puranas. Who created the universe? Who is its preserver and who will destroy it? Please instruct us in all these mysteries."
Romaharshana replied,
"Many years ago, Daksha and the other sages had asked Brahma these very questions. I have learnt about Brahma's replies from my guru, teacher, Vedavyasa. I will relate to you what I know. In the beginning, there was water everywhere and the Brahman, the divine essence, slept on this water in the form of Vishnu. Since water is called Nara and since Ayana means a bed, Vishnu is known as Narayana. In the water there emerged a golden egg,
Anda.
Brahma was born inside this egg. Since he created himself, he is called Swayambhu, born,
Bhu,
by himself,
Swayam.
For one whole year, Brahma lived inside the egg. He then split the egg into two and created Nivan,
Swarg,
and the earth,
Prithvi,
from the two parts of the egg. Skies, directions, time, language and senses were created in both heaven and earth. From the powers of his mind, Brahma gave birth to seven great sages. Their names were Marichi,
Atri, Angira, Pulastya, Pulaha, Kratu,
and Vashishtha. Brahma also created the god Rudra and the sage Santakumara.